Today on Upfront, Wisconsin's new dispute with tribes over spearfishing, why it's flared again and what it could mean for anglers this summer. Plus, why some Republican lawmakers want to give tax credits to parents who send their children to private schools. Then, judicial races in Wisconsin. They're supposed to be nonpartisan. Is this now changing? And the Wisconsin county tackling climate change, hoping to avoid another Lake Delton disaster. It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Boucher.
There's the Wilbur Warrior!
It's an ugly scene from state history now more than two decades old. The Wisconsin walleye wars divided fishermen and Native Americans over tribal fishing rights. Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. Nobody is suggesting it will be like that again, but a new dispute between the Chippewa tribes and the state is flaring over walleye spearfishing. The tribes who are unhappy with mining legislation and the wolf hunt say they'll spear nearly 60,000 walleye in northern Wisconsin this spring. That's about 5,000 more than last year. This will mean non-tribal fishermen get fewer walleye, and that's raised concerns about what it could mean for tourism and has strained the state's relationship with the Chippewa even further. We're talking more about this now with Republican Representative Dean Kaufert of NENA, who chairs the Assembly's Tourism Committee. Representative, it's good to have you on the program.
Thanks for having me.
Well, let me begin with this question. Is there any doubt in your mind that this is pushback from the tribe because it's unhappy with what's been done with mining and what's been done with the wolf hunt in the state?
It sure appears that way. If you heard their reactions initially, they talked a lot about the lack of communication with state officials. They're disappointed in things like the mining legislation, the wolf hunt, and it seems to be some pushback. And they're saying, you know, because we're not getting our way on other issues, we're going to take this stance on spearfishing. And you know, no one hopes it. No one hopes it gets back to where it was in the 80s and that. I don't want to go back there. But I do believe the governor, it's Kathy Stepp, DNR, they need to sit down with the tribes. The tribes need to look at more of look at the big picture and see what this is going to do to the entire state of Wisconsin.
Your concerns are about what this could do to tourism. What do you mean?
Well, you know, as a tourism chair, you know, tourism is a huge business here in the state of Wisconsin. The economic impact is great. And I've talked to many resort owners, supper clubs, you know, bar owners, diner owners up north. They're scared. They are really scared about what this is going to do. Times are hard enough for them right now with the economy. And if people can't go up there and fish, you know, they can get one fish per day. There's a lot of, you know, emails, and I hear anecdotal evidence and people talking to me, and resort owners are saying, Dean, they're just not going to come up to northern Wisconsin to be able to get one fish per day. This is just not going to happen. They're not going to come up here. They're not going to spend their money, and that is going to put my business, my livelihood in jeopardy. And so we as a state, we need to work with the tribes, and we need to figure this out.
Now you've caught some heat for some comments you made. You said maybe the state needs to rethink a $250,000 contribution towards a cultural center that the Chippewa would get. Tim Cullen, your Democratic colleague, he's a senator, said that's thinking from the 1800s. Is there really anything you can do to dissuade the Chippewa from going forward with this?
Well, I hope so, and I've talked to the governor, and, you know, I wasn't there in the 1800s, I would tell Tim Cullen, but, I've seen where we are. I know that the governor has a pretty good relationship with the tribes. He meets with them regularly, and so I'm hoping that, you know, cooler heads will prevail, and we'll get back to that where we were. It was a 16-year agreement with the DNR that the tribes had. For 16 years, they've agreed to that they'd only spear this many fish, and now they've decided to ramp that up. And I hope they understand that the impact on that, what it's going to mean, and that, you know, cooler heads prevail. But there is, you know, one issue as I was looking at this, and we don't have many, you know, we don't have many opportunities to, you know, to try and, you know, look back. But we granted them a grant last budget of $250,000 to the Lac du Flambeau. Right. They haven't accessed that grant yet. And you know what? I just said maybe we should look at that again.
So it's still on the table.
It's still on the table. Quite honestly, if people aren't going to go up there for recreation, maybe we don't need the cultural center grant because people aren't going to be going up there to go there. And the state taxpayers are on the hook for $250,000.
Let me shift gears here and talk about a proposal that came out last week. You and Senator Glenn Grothman, you're talking about tax credits that parents could use for private school tuition. Is this an alternative being presented because there's a belief that the governor's proposal to expand vouchers to 9 more communities is in trouble?
Well, for my case, it's not. Because
it's not an alternative?
Well, I've done this for 10 years. I mean, I've been one of the co-authors of this proposal. So it's been out there. I've been consistent saying, you know what, folks that decide to send their children to private schools, a small amount of tax relief, I think, is appropriate for those individuals. So I did it again this year with Senator Grothman. This year it's getting more attention because of the alternatives out there, the governor's proposal and that. And so it's being called an alternative. It may or may not be. We will see how the governor's proposal turns out. And at that case, people can look at the proposal that Senator Grothman and I put forward. But it's simply, in my case, a feeling that, you know, if a student goes to any school around Wisconsin, the average cost to the state of taxpayers is about $9,000 to $10,000. And if they go to a private school, we're not incurring those expenses. No, you know, we're not spending that money. So I thought a tax credit for those individuals who are, you know, taking the opportunity to send their child and paying the cost, so to speak, a small tax credit would be appropriate. And in addition, in Neenah, my area, vouchers are probably never coming there unless we go statewide voucher system.
A couple of very quick questions. Is this legal? There are some people who've raised legal questions about whether or not you can provide this just for parents who send their kids to private schools.
Yeah, I was asked that question, and there is, I think, a gray area. And so there could be a challenge to it, just like all the laws that we pass. Constitutional questions sometimes do come up.
And what about the cost of this? I've seen estimates as high as $165 million. That's a lot of money.
And that is something that's always held us back. But when you look at the numbers being thrown around now, $79 million for vouchers, the increase for K-12, it's still a big number. That's one thing that troubles me. If there's a way, you know, I've talked to Senator Grothman, but if there's a way to get that number down, clearly you got to bring the tax credit down. But it is a big number.
All right, more to come, I'm sure.
Yeah,
thanks.
Well, thank you.
Thanks very much. Dean Kaufert is a representative from Neenah. We appreciate it. Judicial races in Wisconsin are supposed to be nonpartisan, so why are they sounding more and more like partisan campaigns? I'll be asking former Supreme Court Justice Jeanine Gieske next on Upfront. And later, why one Wisconsin county wants to confront climate change.
Upfront with Mike Gouche, brought to you by American Transmission Company.